Hi everyone, Arlen here. Welcome back to my Country Craft Corner. How in the world are you guys doing today? It is so good to see you again, and thank you so much for stopping back by to see what I'm up to in this, my 2018 Christmas Decor Series episode, I don't know. But in this episode, I'm going to be working on the Christmas lanterns for my kitchen table. I'm so excited, you guys. I'm so excited to finally be getting to this. This will be the last craft on the traditionally colored side of my house. After this, I'll be moving into the two front rooms on the front of my house, where I decorate in a lighter and airier colors, which may seem a little bit untraditional, so to speak, to some, but I love the light. I love the traditional colors, and I love the light and airy colors, and the staircase kind of separates the front from the back of the house, so I feel like I can get away with using a little lighter tone in those rooms. But anyway, this video is the last one for this side of the house, so I'm excited. And I'm also going to be trying something new for me. And I got this idea from you other creators here on YouTube. And that is making two funky bows to put on my one lantern. But anyway, it's hard for me to explain without showing you what I'm doing. So I'm just going to turn my camera around and we're going to get started creating lanterns, three of them. We're not doing three funky bows, but I'm doing a little something with the two smaller ones, and then the double funky bow kind of topper thinger doogle whateverness that turns out to be, I don't know, for the center middle lantern, what will sit in the middle of the table. So anyway, I'll be right back. I'm rambling. I ramble all the time. Oh my goodness. But I'll be right back. I'm going to turn my camera and get it pointed in a way that you all can watch me, and we're going to get started. Be right back. Okie dokie, I'm back. And as you saw, I made one of the funky bows. And of course, I'm going to do a tutorial here for you in just a second. But let me show you the lanterns that I'm going to be using. If you guys haven't seen these lanterns, you can get them. Let me put my camera up a minute before I talk to you here for a second. There we go. You can see the two little ones in the back there. Move this ribbon for just a second. And you can see that I have candles that almost look like snow globes. They have like sparkly things that run around in them. And I got those from Lowe's, if you're interested. And all three of these lanterns came from Walmart. This one is, I believe, 24 inches high. And those are 18 inches high, I believe, or 19. This one is a little bit wider. I have my, here it is. Then the two smaller ones. This one is right about 8 inches almost wide, and these are just about 7 inches wide. Well, I have been trying to decide what to do with these. And then I knew that when Chris brought these home for me that I wanted to put them on my kitchen table for sure. The middle one, the big one in the middle, and then the two littler ones on either side. And then I have two Christmas trees that are kind of flocked ceramic ones that I had last year that have cardinals on them that are gonna sit like kind of right beside the, on either side of the middle one, and then on the inside of the two end ones. So I decided I really didn't want to do anything special. Let me move this out of the way for a second. Anything special to the little ones inside. Mostly because I wanted the center one to do all the talking, so to speak. So all I did with these was just add the candle in, as you can see. And then I found some bells from And That, and they were like $1.99, something like that. And these I had to stretch this a little bit, but they just fit right over the top. I'm not gonna put bows on these at all. And I'm thinking about, I was gonna pour snow in here, and then I decided, no, I don't want the mess, because these lanterns will be moved on and off of this table a good bit. So I picked up some of this from Hobby Lobby last week, and I thought, well, maybe this will work as faux snow, you know? So I'm not gonna lift these candles up. It's really hard to find a white, trust me. Let me see if I can get this off of here. A white candle holder. I haven't been able to find one this week, so we're not gonna worry about it. Plus, I want them to be lower profile than the middle one anyway, so it worked out fine. Cut up a couple of little pieces of this. Now, also too, as you can see, there's some wires on this candle, and those are nothing that came with the candle. This is Chris getting ready to rig this up with an external battery, and he's gonna run the little cables, they're just little cables like this, underneath my table runner out there, and I'll explain that more to you when we get out that direction. Anyway, I am just simply gonna cut, you know, little pieces of this and use it as a little bit of a candle ring. I'm not even gonna tie it together, you guys. I think it'll be fine just like that. And I have batteries in these candles right now just for to show you guys, just for this purpose. But the batteries won't need to be in here apparently anymore, as so Chris tells me. So I think that's gonna look pretty. Just, that is, if I can get it to control itself and get it in there. I'm gonna push it down a bit. I think that's gonna be pretty. There we go. And that's all I'm doing with the two side ones. You're going to be able to see these, of course, from all four sides. Let me do one for this one. Now, let's get this big mama over here. And I'm going to do the same thing for around this candle ring. And here. This one I did find a little metal, like a little cake stand in at Hobby Lobby, and it fits in here perfectly. And I mean, there's no space, there's no wiggle room in there. So this candle is not gonna go anywhere once it's in there. I think I am going to put a bit around the bottom of this and around on the top of it. You know, I was gonna do pip berries in here, and I was gonna do this and that, and I'm like, nope, I'm not. I want this to be understated. I think, my goodness, so we have three lanterns. I think that's gonna be plenty. Some around the bottom. And then, well, that was pretty silly of me, wasn't it? Put some around the top of it. You can't really even see the little stand. There we go. Now, if I want to, after Chris rigs these things up, I have these little, like, candy canes. And I was thinking, you know, if I wanted to, I'm not even sure I want to do this, but I could stick, you know, candy cane here and there, but you know, I'm not even sure I'm gonna even do that, to be honest. I might just want these, just the bows, to speak for themselves. Now, All right, so that's it for the inside of these lanterns. I still have a little bit of this left to use somewhere else, maybe on my white tree or something, I don't know. I did buy two sets of bigger bells, and these are going to be the first thing to go on this lantern. I don't think the top part is any bigger, at least I hope not, then. So here is the front. I need to put it over this first, and then I kind of snug it down. Oh, please fit. I felt that one crack, but that's okay. It's gonna be under the bows anyway. So that's right. This must be a smidge bigger than the little ones. I'm going to do is tie this one funky bow on that I did, and I've fluffed it a little bit, but I haven't fluffed it all the way, but I am going to go ahead and add it, and we'll put this one on the back side of what would be the back side of the lantern. And I need to extend my pipe cleaner here. I don't know whether this is going to work out. We'll see. I hope it will. Do some fluffing here. Okay, so that's the back side. Now we're going to do a funky bow for the front side. And I have a bunch of stuff sitting here. And I'm going to see how this bow looks, and I may be adding some berries to it, or, you know, probably not too much greenery, but I might take out some of the icy looking berries. I'll just leave the back of this right like that for now. And I'm probably going to have to do some trimming of tails and so on. Okie dokie, I am doing a 12 loop funky bow. That's what that one is. And I'm gonna do one exactly the same as that. I will tell you, I had to cut, and I have three strips of each type of ribbon cut at 26 inch lengths, except for the Joy to the World. The Joy to the World is cut about 23, because I tried to get most of the Joy to the World in it so that you would be able to see it. Not that you can see one of them here. Where are all the Joy to the World? Here's one, you know. So, and it really doesn't matter. Oh, you can see a Joy there and World there. So it doesn't matter, and Joy down here. So it'll be what it is. But anyway, in my mind, I had to start it out like that. So let me get another couple of pipe cleaners here. Like I said, this is going to be a 12 loop funky bow. So in effect, you just fold one loop in half, or one strip of ribbon in half. And with each strip of ribbon, you're going to have measure out at five inches after you fold it in half, and that will give you a 5-inch loop and 2 5-inch tails. Pinch it together right there at 5 inches, go to that back tail and twist to bring the pattern to the right side, or to the same side. And as you see, they all get, you know, crazy and askew, but that's okay. At least you're going to start them out that way. Then you're going to go through the pattern with a 12 loop funky bow. We're going to go through the pattern of ribbons once with the loop pointing up from my thumb, which is what I call center of the bow. This is going to be the center of the bow. So the first time through the pattern, we're going to point the loop up from center. Inches, pinch, and to go back, that back tail, you can see those tails are a little bit shorter, so I had to cut that strip a little bit shorter. I love this plaid. Isn't this plaid pretty? Ugh. I have a real affinity for plaids, but anyway, there we go. Now, so that's our first time through the pattern with the loops all pointing up from center, which is my thumb. Here we go, we're gonna start the pattern again, pardon me, and we're gonna point that loop down from center, and I'm just twisting it around there to get the birdhouses going in the same direction. Not that it matters, in my mind it does though, at first, twist that back tail. And all through this pattern, we're going to point that loop down from center. See that? Gets all your tails dispersed at first, you know, when you do that, when you switch directions with the ribbon. You can pull them and yank them any way you want, to be honest with you, but kind of makes it easier to have them kind of going that way. Plus, it's organized. And I am very organized, and I like things to be done in a methodical, organized fashion. It helps me teach first how to do them, and it helps me remember how to do them, you know? So I've kind of made this little, if you will, cheat sheet. If you go to my Instagram, you can find a Funky Bow cheat sheet on there in a PDF form. Actually, it's in JPEG form. I put pictures of them. Anyway, all right, here we go. With the next time through the pattern, pointing that loop up from center. You can find the link to my Instagram in the description, or if you go up to the little cover shot, there's a little icon there, and you can just click on that and go to my Instagram. Little link up there. Anyway, we're about finished. We're going the last time through the pattern, pointing the loop up from center. Just flipped it to make the joy go the same direction throughout the bow. Last one. There we go. And twist that back tail. Grab your pipe cleaner. Pinch it together too. Before you put your pipe cleaner on, pinch it together as tightly as you can. And lay it beside your thumb. Find the center. Lay it beside your thumb. Lift your thumb if you can. Pull it around to the back from the bottom and then from the top. Use the hand you're holding the bow shut with as resistance. Pinch. And twist. I twist both. Some people just twist the bow, which actually does make it tighter. I twist both. I'm gonna go ahead and add these second little pipe cleaners on here. Give me a little bit more room. And we'll do a little fluffing. Remember, the most important part of any bow that you make is the fluffing. Don't be afraid to get in there and fluff out every single loop. Pull the loops forward at first. You may want to put them to the back with this a little bit once we get it on. We're going to see if we can get these bows to mingle with one another. As I say, this is the first time I've ever tried this. Y'all gave me this idea, you creators. I think the first one I saw do it was Susan over there at Susan's Cozy Condo. And then I saw Danielle at Danielle's Decor do it. So I'm thinking, well, goodness, girls, I can do this. So I'm trying it. And we'll see. All right. That's pretty good for now. Let me see if I can figure out a way to muscle this thing on here. Let me put this up. Hopefully I can keep it in the picture. So let's see here. Really no top or bottom.
Okay.
Wow. Check it out. Pulling it as tight as I can, you guys. Okay. Well then, I think this is going to be super pretty. One thing I do miss, and that I might do here instead of pipe cleaners, I don't know how you guys did it, but I think I'm going to put a little piece of ribbon behind and tie a little ribbon. I don't feel like I have it tight enough with these pipe cleaners. Let me see here. And I'm not going to be tying a bow. Well, I might tie a little bow underneath of it. One piece of ribbon into the pipe cleaner in the back, just attaching it. And this way I can pull this bow really close to the lantern. Let me take this off too before I... That's the only thing I can see. And y'all might have done this and I just missed that step. Gonna tie a little quick little bow, but the difference is I'm gonna tie it really tight there like that and pull the, do I have it on the front? Yes. And pull the bow really close. And I do want to tie a bow in the back, which you won't see when the other bow is laying on top of it. So I better make it a pretty bow, huh? Jeez. But I just feel like it's more sturdy that way. Okay. I think I got this plaid ribbon from craftoutlet.com, you guys. No, I got this from an Etsy shop. I don't remember which one. If I can find a link, I'll link it for you. So I'm gonna do the same thing over here. Again, I'm just tying it really tight. I'm pulling that bow up as close as I can get it to the lantern to make it nice and tight. Okie dokie. This is one massive bow. I'm still playing with it. Now, my question is, do we need even more with this? I don't think I want to do anything one-sided, if you get my drift. If I'm going to do anything, I'm going to do some of these berries. But this is all I have of these. And maybe that's not a bad thing. Let me see here. And I want them to match on both sides. I want them to be the same, which will be a challenge, I think. Somewhat the same. Anyway. And I think I'm not going to go crazy, you guys. I've got my hot glue gun here. I really am not.
Ooh.
Crazy enough. Get up, Sam. Time for supper. I think that'll be about it, you guys. Don't want to go crazy on this. I'm gonna let this dry and do a little bit more tweaking to it, and then I'll be back for some final words. Okie dokie, everybody, here I am, all finished. Oh my goodness, I did add a little poinsettia in the middle here and a little poinsettia in the back bow, and I was a little bit of an engineer myself. Give myself a point. I took little command strips, hooks, and I decided I wanted to use just two of these little Jingle Bell ornaments that I got from Walmart, and I'm simply using the hook that they had hooked in the store. I may change that out to a ribbon, but for this purpose, I wanted to just show you. So I just hooked it right underneath, you know, I put there's a little lip here, and I just put the command strip hook underneath there and then hooked the little hook on it. And I have a bell hanging in the back and a bell hanging in the front, and then the three bells hanging on the sides. Go me. Oh my goodness. But anyway, I'm very happy with how this turned out. I'm surprised that it came together, being that this was my first time trying this, so I was really happy with it. I'm still messing with it and tweaking it, and I'm sure I'll do that every time I walk by it. But I said I have to stop and go give these kind folks some final words here. So I'm gonna say my final words, and then I'll take a silent video, as I always do, around the table over there, where you can see everything set up with the tablecloth and the table runner and the other two lanterns and the two Christmas trees. I think it's gonna look pretty over there. But anyway, before I say goodbye, let me just say that I hope that those of you who are, because I know there are some of you out there who are struggling with a catastrophic illness or chronic pain, I hope that you have someone there with you, spending their days with you, helping you get through each day, making the very, very best out of each day. I hope there's nothing weighing on your minds or your hearts, pulling your attention away from where it should be or where you want it to be. I love you guys to bits, to bits, to bits. Hugs all around, and I keep you in my thoughts and prayers every single day. And remember, in crafting, there are no mistakes, only unique creations. Next up, we're going to move into the lighter and airier side of my Christmas decor with the living room and dining room. I have no clue where I'm going to start in there, you guys, but this was the last craft over on this side of the house. I feel pretty accomplished over here. But anyway, for now, I'll just say until next time, y'all take good, good care. Bye-bye.
Thank you.